Welcome to our Tech Tuesday. Our topic today is e-mobility in commercial vehicles, more efficiency through innovative drive solutions. My guests today are Jobst Tölle for the sales department of e-mobility and Boris Schneider, software engineer for the e-mobility solutions here at KBB. Yeah, welcome. Good to have you here today. Our topic is e-mobility in commercial vehicles. But first, could you please introduce shortly yourself for the audience?
Sure. Hello. Thanks for the invitation. My name is Jobst Tölle and I'm in the sales department for e-mobility. So I'm responsible for all the projects and customer from the automotive sector. They want to use the T6.
Mm-hmm. My name is Boris Schneider. I'm responsible for the software engineering. I created most of the software in the T6, or at least in the control part of the T6. Mm-hmm.
So my first question is for you, Jobst. Why are commercial vehicles electrified?
That's a big topic all over the world. The CO2 emissions are too high, and one of the strategy to reduce these CO2 emissions is to electrify the vehicles also in the city, like bus, like trucks, or something like that.
Mm-hmm. And what requirements do customers have?
The first requirement is that our customer want to have an automotive specified product. There are a lot of standards. The T6 has to fully, like ECE R10 for the EMC, and they want to have a product with a high protection class, like EP67, mm-hmm. that they can also mount the T6 outside of the bus or the truck, and it's possible so you don't have any trouble with rain or snow, for example. Mm-hmm. And they want to have a system that is easy to install and also easy for first commissioning.
What kind of products and solutions can KBB offer its customers?
First of all, we have our T6 APD. It's a mobile inverter system for auxiliary drives in the vehicle. For example, the steering pump or heating system or air compressor, and the T6 can run every motor like asynchronous or synchronous motor without any encoder feedback. So you do not need an encoder signal to run the T6 with a motor in speed or torque controlled mode. And we have inside the MCU, it's a pre-programmable logic control, and therefore we have, or Boris has created a specific software, we call it App Utility.
Mm-hmm. So you talked about software. And I think I heard something about the software app utility. Boris, maybe you can tell me what's about this.
Yeah, the app utility works like an operating system on the T6, comparable like operating system on cell phones. And it offers a pool of applications that can be selected and assigned to the different nodes, like maybe you have a steering pump and a compressor unit, and the behavior of these two applications needs to be different. Then we have different software packages in this pool that can be assigned to these motors.
Mm-hmm. Such an app pool is obviously very helpful. And what does KBB already offer for the customers?
Well, most of all, we have some generic apps that can be used for anything, and they just control like the torque or the speed of a motor, or with different field bus connections like CANopen or J1939, which is pretty common in the in this area. But there are also specific applications for specific use cases like hydraulic pumps or steering pumps or compressors or heating pumps or generator modules. Yeah.
And in what applications is the T6 already used with these software apps?
The most common is the public transportation area. But we also have applications in the agriculture area and for commercial vehicles or trucks. And the typical use cases are, as I already said, steering pump, heating pumps, hydraulic pumps, air compressors, and the generator modules.
So can one of you explain me this generator application? What does that mean?
The application creates or has a possibility to regulate the DC voltage in the inner circuit. So you can basically define a voltage you want to have in your circuit, and the module is connected to a generator and it generates this energy needed. It can be an energy storage, or it can also work without an energy storage. If there is one, the software can regulate the current which is used to charge the storage. And if there is none, it automatically adjusts to the load. But the application in the field, I did not start one up yet. No. Jobst did it already, so he can tell you more about this.
Sure. We have, for example, one customer from the area of agriculture machinery. And he had the situation that he wants to electrify a sweeper, and therefore he don't want to use the battery because battery systems are really expensive. And then he connected the generator motor with the PTO of a tractor,
for example. Okay. So finally, maybe one more question to both of you. What would convince you if you were the customer of the T6? What are the special features?
Yeah, maybe I start. The T6 is a system for the customer, and he can order it with one axis for the motor up to six. It depends what the customer needs and how many auxiliaries you want to electrify, and that we can run every motor without encoder. It's a big benefit. And also the MCU inside, but I think Boris, you can say more about it.
Yeah, I think especially the MCU and also the design of the device brings a lot of flexibility. So it is exactly adjusted to the demand of the customer. If he has a vehicle that needs just two auxiliaries, like a steering and compressor, which is the most common one, he orders a T6 with two nodes. But if they have, for example, a bus with a double angle module, they need a lot of air conditioning units, they need two steering pumps, they need way more auxiliaries like in a small bus. So they just order the T6 with a larger module and it will perfectly fit in their use case.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Very interesting topic. And also thank you for watching. If you have any question, don't hesitate to write us an email at webinar@keb.de. Thank you.